Tonight on Access TV, live live with Gotham Comedy Live. Get ready to laugh with Owen Benjamin, Roy Wood Jr., Ahmed Ahmed, Gareth Reynolds, and your host, Steve Byrne. From the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, live, all happening right now. Ladies and gentlemen, your host, Steve Byrne.
Hi. Hi. Don't talk, just clap. How are you? Welcome. Hey! I was just joking. Don't touch me again. Gotham Comedy Live. Thank you guys so much for coming out tonight. Gonna be a great show. Thank you. A little too much. What's your name? Fuck you, Luke. All right, everyone else was quiet, but Luke had to stand out. We get it, dude. A long shift at Urban Outfitters. Let's relax. Thanks for coming, Luke. Great hair. We got a great show here tonight with you, for you guys. Thank you guys so much for coming out tonight. We want to thank Access TV for being so kind to have us on there. Yeah. And this show is live. You guys know it's live, right? I mean, it is so live. If it wasn't live, could I do this? No. You don't see that when things are take. Could I do? Give me your straw, black guy. Could I do that in front of a black guy? Could I do that normally? But that's live. And if he hit me, it would be really live. But he is black, but the glasses kind of make me think you're not as black as I normally would think you're black, but you are fast. That's, That's live. That's live. Back up. Nice to see some Asians here. Very nice. Turn around. Boo. Boo. Did you see that? Turn around. Boo. Black. Just letting you know. Definitely black. I've seen a few black people in my day, and that dude is definitely fucking black. Sir, what's your Asian? What's your name? We'll just call you Asian. Asian, if you saw this gentleman walking down the street at 4 a.m, would you cross to that? Would you be a little nervous? What would you be thinking? Just tell me. If you just saw him without the glasses, first off, let's just say that. Astigmatism aside, if you just saw that husky looking, probably cut from Rutgers as a wide receiver black guy walking down the street, would you be a little, just be honest, look at me. Would you be a little nervous?
I think he looks absolutely good.
That's, yeah. You hear the quivering? You hear the quivering? Now, sir, the gentleman, the Democrat. What's it called? If it's 4 a.m. and you're walking down the street and you see this Asian coming towards you, do you think they're still delivering? I think that's what I think. So, I don't know. You do the math. And I'm talking to the Asian, not the fucking black guy, when I say you do the math. So good. Very nice. Dating here? Dating? Good. With those pants? Really? They're okay, yeah. All right. Do you see these pants? Some people's screens at home burst because they're just, oh God, in the front row too. I mean, look at all these seats you could have sat. What's that? They knew it was going to happen. So they put you up front, yeah. But God bless you. You look like one of those dudes in Apocalypto, so I'm just going to back off. And, yeah. Good, good. How do you two know each other? How do you guys know each other? Did you not hear me with this fucking microphone? I'm like, okay. Where do you guys work? It doesn't matter, right? It doesn't matter. But that's good. So you've been dating this gentleman, right? You've been dating. Very nice. Has he ever been on television? No, I have. So just remember that. throughout the course of the evening, remember that. Was that the... What sound was that? Nothing? It's live. Tate, you wouldn't see that. But even a professional, such as I am, got thrown. So... I said, fuck you earlier to you, right? I take it back. Fuck you. So, not cool. Not cool at all. Live show. You two are dating? Very nice. Interracial? Ooh. These two are dating. Oh. The two guys are dating. Well, I think we got another comedian here, ladies and gentlemen. Young lady, you want to take the mic? Because you are on fire. Very nice. Well, I just want to say, when you two met at the club tonight, and you walked in, or you walked in, and you looked at the shirts, were you like, oh, fuck? You had to, kind of, right? You looked at each other's shirts, you went, oh, fuck, and then this jackass with these pants came in, you go, we're good now. We're all good. Everything's fine again. Okay, good. Well, thank you for wearing those pants, because you made a lot of dudes in this room feel a little bit better about themselves. Especially this one, but God bless. All right. Now, you guys married, dating? Married, Derek, what? You, dating, good. How long? 6 months? Not going to work out, just letting you know. So, you probably got another month or two left in the tank, so, you know. Hey, am I lying here? Give it another month. Yeah, whatever. You know what? You guys are going to show the world. You'll beat the odds. This one's going to work. It's not going to work. You won't. How'd you meet? Craigslist? It's sexy. Sexy. Good. At a bar. Very nice. Do you remember your first date? Where'd you go? Guys, this is live. Let's go. This is fucking live. I don't got time for... Fuck you. I'm joking. Just joking. You met at a bar. Very nice. Good looking couple, though. Good looking. Very nice. Good. Good. I'm lying. I'm joking. You guys, you're going to make it happen. I like this. Jonas Brother hair. Does he have Jonas Brother hair? It's very Disney hair. And this one. Wow. I love it. If I were you, I would just grow it out and go everywhere horseback. Just like... Like, let your neck snap back and just let it, like your hair break dance, almost. Good. And you two are dating? Married. Very nice. Good. And glasses as well? Very nice. So you know when you go into the bedroom and... Can I borrow them for a second? You go into the bedroom and Mama goes, what's your name? Michael? Kenny. Whatever. She goes, Greg, come here. And she's in a naive, whatever, it's your fantasy. And then she goes like this. You know you're gonna get fucked up. Right? I don't even, not like take the glasses off and slam them. I'd rather see, get the fuck over here, big boy. It's like, gently. Just gently put them on the nightstand. Yeah, just as the glasses go down, call a chiropractor. I'm gonna need to see you tomorrow. My spine's gonna get fucked up. Well, we got a great show tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Some of the members, everybody on the show tonight is from Sullivan and Son on TBS. Yes! Got our second season coming up. June 13th, but tonight we're here on Gotham Comedy Live. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Gareth Reynolds is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Hey guys, welcome back. Gotham Comedy Live. We are definitely live. This is a very live show. You couldn't do that if it's not live. We got to keep the show going with our first comedian. He's a great pal of mine. He actually is a guest star this season on Sullivan and Son. I know him from, we actually did a show together years ago on NBC called The Real Wedding Crashers. You know, not to be confused with the movie that made millions of dollars. We were on The Real Wedding Crashers, the show that got canceled after four episodes. So he's had a show on MTV called Philosophy. He's a great improv guy and a great stand-up comedian. And ladies and gentlemen, he's not allowed to come up here until I say his whole name. So just stand there. You're going to love him. His name is Gareth Reynolds, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Keep it going for me. Thank you. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. I appreciate that, everybody. Hello, everybody. Thank you for coming out. God, your pants really are bananas. I don't know what to say. Holy shit. I don't know whether to run or peel you. I don't know what's going on over there. A lot of beautiful couples here tonight. I'm single. Got out of a relationship pretty recently. Single, ready to fingle. See, one of the reasons I got out of a relationship was I had really, really bad girlfriend voice. See, girlfriend voice has nothing to do with catfishing, manti tail. Girlfriend voice is what happens to your voice as a man when you talk to your girlfriend on the phone and you're around your buddies. Something happens to your voice where all the strength and the masculinity drains from you. You sound like a Muppet more than a man. It's fucking pathetic. I'd be watching a football game with my buddies and be like, let's go, we gotta stop the run, this is bullshit. This offseason we draft nothing but linebackers. I gotta take this, but I am pissed off. Hey, baby. Hi. How's my baby? Yay. I'm good. I'm just over at Dave's watching the big game. Yes, fam, we ordered Papa John's. Yeah, I'm dipping in the garlic sauce. I'm crazy. Hey, baby, let me call you when I leave here, okay? Baby? I love you.
You walk back over, your buddy's like, what the fuck just happened to you? Who was that? Because you can't say I love you to your girlfriend in a voice like that. Can't do it, so I came up with code. I told her, I'm like, I'm not going to say I love you anymore when I'm around my buddies. Instead of that, I'm going to say, I think I left the stove on. Some smart shit. She knows what I'm talking about. They're none the wiser. So I'd be on the phone like, okay, baby, well, let me call you when I leave here, okay? Wait, baby? I think I left the stove on. Walk back over now, like, who was that? You're like, my girlfriend. She was like, I smell gas. What an idiot. She's an idiot. What a whore. Give it to me. But it's hard as a relationship progresses. Trying to get off the phone with a lady, you know? Sometimes I'd be huddled in the corner and be like, okay, baby, well, let me call you when I leave here, okay? Baby? I think I left the stove on. Of course I think I left the stove on. What makes you think that I don't think that I left the stove on? Wouldn't say I thought I left the stove on if I didn't think I left the stove on. Baby, the stove is on and it is piping hot, okay? From the second I saw you, it was, I think I left the stove on at first sight. I have never left the stove on with anyone like this before. When I get home, I'm gonna make sweet, sweet, I think I left the stove on. Maybe put a finger in the oven. Maybe! It's just a little appliance talk, gang. So I went and got tested for STDs recently. Anyone done that? Okay, one man.
I'm gonna think about that. As I was sitting in the waiting room of that establishment, I thought to myself, isn't it crazy that the only person on record to have beaten AIDS has a name like Magic Johnson? What are the fucking odds of that? His name literally translates to wizard dick, and he beat AIDS.
All right, all right, all right, I'm pandering.
Holy shit. What? I don't know what's going on over there, but I think someone's murdering an animal. So I live in Los Angeles. Kill it already! So I live in Los Angeles. First moved to Los Angeles, the first job I got when I got there was I used to dress up like superheroes for kids' birthday parties. Yes, thank you, sir, who got tested for AIDS. Same fucking guy. I think he just woos setups. That's what I think the deal is with him. Used to dress up like superheroes for kids' birthday parties. Whatever it was, I would just show up to some stranger's house dressed up like Batman or Superman or Winnie the Pooh. It was pathetic. It was the worst job I've ever had. It was a nightmare. You know, one time I was dressed up like Spider-Man and I got stung by a bee through the spandex. And I reacted how I would react, not how Spider-Man would react in that situation. I was just keeled over in some stranger's yard like, oh boy, that burns. Oh, owie, owie, owie. Oh my God, does that sting? It's very painful. And the kids are like, didn't you beat the Green Goblin? I'm like, yeah, of course I beat the Green Goblin. He was a goblin, this is a bee. And I'm a spider. So we're both insects. So he got into the spider's phylum and he outfuck you. Piece of shit. One time I was dressed up like Buzz Lightyear for a one-year-old. Look how awful that is. Who's got young kids? I know you don't. You got blue balls, but no kids. How old?
18 months.
18 months. What did you do when that adorable kid turned one?
Freaked out.
Freaks? It's not the right answer. You didn't do a birthday party, though, right? That's the enemy. See, don't do that. Don't waste your money on a one-year-old because a one-year-old doesn't know anything. The brain is mush. It's gravy. Nobody looks back on their life and is like, my favorite birthday? Oh, man, when I was one. It's really good. I think about it all the time. So I'm dressed up like Buzz Lightyear for this one-year-old's birthday party, and I somehow get through this bullshit. And the point is, like, when Buzz Lightyear walks into a one-year-old's birthday party, a one-year-old doesn't go like, oh, my God, it's Buzz Lightyear from my favorite movie. Yay! No. Gravy. Buzz Lightyear walks into a one-year-old's birthday party, a one-year-old is like, oh, my God, I have hands! So I finish this party, and I'm walking to my car, still dressed as Buzz Lightyear, which to me is really the walk of shame. A lot of people think a one-night stand is a walk of shame. That's not a walk of shame. You just had sex with a stranger and are by yourself. To me, best-case scenario. Walk of shame, being 30 years old, dressed as Buzz Lightyear, walking to a Honda Civic that's probably not going to start, eating a Dixie cup full of pasta that a Russian mom just gave you as a tip. That's a shameful walk. So I'm taking that walk. And as I get towards my car, I hear this 5-year-old kid from a bounce house. And he goes, hey, Buzz Lightyear. And I sort of stop. I'm like, yeah, kid. And he goes, suck my dick. I was like, okay, things are good. Things feel good. Professionally, I'm at a 10 right now. That was nice. And you know what's crazy? I blow that kid, I'm the weirdo. I don't care how much Buzz loves Woody, that is not going down. Guys, glad to end on that. My name's Gareth Reynolds. Enjoy the rest of the show. Thank you very much.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Ahmed is taking the stage when we return.
All right, guys. Welcome back. Gotham Comedy Live. Just real quick, you guys are awesome. Give yourselves a round of applause. You guys are unreal. We got to keep the show going. You're going to love this next gentleman. All the guys that you're going to see on the show are actually playing their real names, and this guy is one of my best pals. He was one of the first guys I met when I moved to Los Angeles, and I couldn't. When I was writing the script for Sullivan Son, he was the first name I put in as one of the barflies. He's awesome. He just had a Showtime movie called Just Like Us, which is a great documentary. He's been on Comedy Central. You guys are going to love him. How about a big round of applause for our first African-American of the evening, Mr. Ahmed Ahmed!
I love that guy. How you doing, New York City? All right. Thanks. thanks for coming out. I gotta tell you, I love New York City. It's actually really beautiful during the day. Yeah, because when the sun goes down, it turns into fucking I Am Legend outside. What's wrong with all the people just... I'm like... Homeless guy came up to me tonight right when I was walking in. He's like, hey, man, what do you do here at the Comedy Hut? I was like, it's called Gotham, but... And why are you scratching like that? What's going on there? What is that? I was like, oh, I'm a comedian. He's like, oh, yeah, tell me a fucking joke. So I told him a joke. He laughed so hard, he farted. Which I didn't see coming, and then my knee-jerk reaction was to laugh, and then I laughed so hard I sharted. So, but I cleaned up and I'm back. It's nice to be here. I'll be 43 next month. Woo! Yeah. Thanks. Thank you. Thank you. I know I look great. I do, so if you didn't laugh or clap, you might want to go home and look at yourselves, just so you know. Gonna be 43. I'm tired all the time. I'm taking like 3 naps a day. I took 3 naps today. Back to back, mind you. Like, anybody over 40 in here, clap if you're over 40. See how tired and miserable they were over there? Sir, you didn't even clap. You're just like, finish the joke, bro. Sorry. My friends took me to Vegas for my birthday. They're like, we're going to Vegas. We're going to meet chicks. I'm 42, dude. Have you seen To Catch a Predator? I don't want to be on TV like that. Besides, I don't talk to chicks anymore. I talk to cougars. Where are my cougars at? That a girl. That's it? No more cougs? You better clap. You better. That's it? All right. Saber-toothed tigers and a saber-toothed sinner? No sense. We were in Vegas, and we're at the casino in the hotspot, and the young chicks in the miniskirts and the high heels are whizzing by us. I'm just like, oh. I got confused. I didn't know how to run my game anymore. I didn't have that swagger. When I was in my 20s and 30s, I'd walk up to a girl like I was going to commit a fucking crime. Like, hey, what's your name? What's your number? Can I get you a drink? It was like some Animal Planet shit. Primal, like trying to connect ponytails like an avatar and shit. But then you hit your 40s and it's like, oh, look at her, she's hot. Fuck, she's fast. Yeah. She'll be back. She has to walk right here, though, okay? I can't go all the way over there because my sciatica nerve will kick in. So. I was in a relationship with a girl that was in her 20s, and nothing against girls here if you're in your 20s, because you're all beauticians, all of you. Just little beauties with no point of view. I'm sorry, you just haven't lived life, no experience, no wisdom. But a lot of fucking pouting. Yeah. A lot of fucking pouting and fussing going on for no reason. Be like, hey, babe, you want to get some dinner or something? Yep, someone woke the baby. All right, we don't have to eat. Let's go see a movie instead. Are you fucking retarded? What's happening here? You didn't act like that when I met you on Facebook. That's all I'm saying. Oh, really? You're all on Facebook too, poking and stabbing and liking and tagging. Who's on Facebook in here? Clap if you're using Facebook. Nice. Who's not on Facebook in here? Who's not using Facebook? Oh, really? Ooh, still using MySpace, huh? I was in a relationship with a girl who broke up with me for smoking weed. You guys know her? Oh. She was all right. She just had one of those personalities of, she was a bitch, basically. She's like, I don't date people who do drugs, so you have to make up your mind. It's either me or your pot. Which is it? I was like, yeah, come on, let's stop fighting and tell me where you're hiding the fucking Doritos, all right? This is, Daddy's got the munchies, let's go. Thank you. I'm gonna miss you. I was trying to explain to her that it's a plant, it's an herb, it grows from the ground, the good Lord put it here, we didn't put the shit here. And she wasn't hearing it, so I had to sit her down one night, whip out the Bible, and explain to her over and over the story of Moses and the burning bush. You guys know the story, huh? She didn't know it. You know the story, sir? They say that God spoke to Moses through a burning bush. Yeah, because I believe the bush was burning. Perhaps it was burning because Moses was fucking smoking it. That's why. Yeah. They say he came down the mountain with a glazed look on his face. No wonder he was lost in the desert for 40 fucking years. You gotta be high. I heard there's some Middle Eastern people here in the house. Nice. Where are you from?
Jordan.
I've been to Jordan. I'm from Egypt. Nothing against anybody else in the Middle East, but Egyptians were the first civilization known to man right here. You're welcome, I guess. I mean, we built the pyramids. Okay, technically the Jews built the pyramids. Always taking credit for everything. But we designed and supervised. And if you're not laughing, you're probably a Jew. So you guys have been a lot of fun. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Roy Wood Jr. is taking the stage when we return. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
Guys, welcome back. I'm going to show you how live this show is. This was not expected. We were not planning this. But I'm going to bring up a co-star of mine. We're going to introduce the very next gentleman that's going to be performing. Ladies and gentlemen, she plays my high school crush on Sullivan and Son. She plays Melanie Sutton. How about it for Valerie Aslan, everybody? Come on up here. Easy, black guy. Easy. Do you want to just bring him up?
Yeah.
Give him a nice intro.
Well, I'll dump Steve on TV for him. Roy Wood Jr. Woo!
All right. Thank you. Thank you. You can stop. Stop it. You're a bunch of liars. Yeah. Wearing my white gang safe colors tonight, man. That's what it's like. That's what it's like when you're black. You have to worry about what color you're gonna wear when you leave the house, because the gang may not like you. I live in LA now. You'd wear a red shirt. And first of all, I'm in my 30s. I should be allowed to wear a red shirt again. Like when is the cutoff, gang members? When can I start back wearing red again? Because in my 20s, I obeyed you. I didn't wear red, I didn't wear blue, and now I want to look nice. It was a two-button polo, and I'm at the gas station, and this dude just comes up, yeah, you wearing red, you get dead. You wear red, you get dead. I'm like, sir, I have a blazer on top of this. This, it's an outfit, man. I'm not in a gang. Even if I was in a gang, obviously, I'm a supervisor. You have no right to speak out of line. Who is your Crip supervisor? I need your badge number. I will report you to Crip. I will go to Crip.org and log in and leave you a bad review. I got in an argument with my uncle, man. My uncle, like, just, you ever have somebody give you a gift they think is a good gift and you sitting there scratching your head? Like, who told you that this? Yes. But for my birthday, this is for real. For my birthday, my uncle gave me a $50 gift card with $12 left on it. Why? Why, Uncle Derek? Just why? What am I gonna do with $12? You gonna put $8 with it and get you a 2 for $20. That's what you gonna do. I'm like, that's not what I wanna do. Sick of arguing with people, man. That's all I do now. And I argue about stupid stuff. Like, you think I would be running around arguing about gun control or some real debate in this country? But I got into an argument. You know what they're doing now in this country? You know, little tricky shit they do now. They're charging us for sauce when we get the nuggets from the fast food spot. Yeah, this is our America now. This is what Obama did to me. I voted for him, and now he's charging for sauces. And it's not the fact that you're charging me 25 cents for a sauce. You want to be an ass, fine, be an ass. But the dude was like, well, you know, I just can't give you the sauce. And I'm like, why not? Nobody's looking, just slide it across the counter. Okay, I can't, brother, okay? It's not up to me, brother. If it was up to me, I would give you a sauce. Bitch, it is up to you. It's on your side of the counter. You're in charge of the sauce. Yeah, but y'all worried about gas prices. That's what y'all want to talk about. $4 a gallon of gas going up to $5 a gallon. I could give a damn. It's the sauce is a quarter. That's what we need to be talking about. Just talk about what's real, man. That's all they do. Nickel and dime or some stuff that we don't think twice about. That's how the companies get the money. Open your eyes, New York. You worried about $4 gas. A small soda at the movies is $10.50. Did you know that? Huh? You know that? Did you ever mess up and get thirsty at the movies and have to go see a loan officer just to quench your thirst for $10, a 20-ounce Pepsi? It'd be cheaper to drink a gallon of gas. You'd be better off. I mean, I mean, you'd die, but you'd save $6. That's all that matters at that point. No, man. Some of you coupled up, that's cool. I try to break up couples. That's my move, man. Dude, you see somebody out holding hands, you just, that's what I do. I walk up to the girl while she out with the guy, I look the girl dead in her face. Oh, so you back with this motherfucker, and just walk off. And you leave. As soon as you say that, you leave, because he's gonna have questions you can't answer. You gotta get out of there. Yeah. My little cousin's getting married. He's using that to brag on the family. And, you know, and like, you know, I'm at this point now where I'm not married and I don't have kids. So now, like, I'm 2 years away from the gay rumors. I already know it. Like, no, because I'm from the South. I'm from Alabama. And, like, if you're not married by 35, your grandma just starts saying weird stuff to you at family get together. Jesus loves you no matter what. Like, what you mean? What does that mean? Oh, nothing, baby. I just wanted to tell you that God loves all this shit. I will clamp your oxygen tube shut. Say something else. Say something else. It's just not right. My little cousin got a living will done. Now he's bragging about it. And now everybody in the family, they're pestering us. So you need to get a will, Roy. Why don't you have your life together? You need to get a will done. You can be in a wreck. You can't speak for yourself. And that paperwork is the only weapon that you have to make sure that you have. I'm not saying you don't need to have a will, okay? It's an important document to have, but don't be in a rush to get the shit. Look, if you don't have a will, there's literally, there's nothing more depressing than to walk around your house making a list of what you want to give away when you die, only to discover that you have nothing to give away. That's it. I was walking around the house, I'm doing inventory, I got a George Foreman grill and a Shrek 2 DVD. That's it. That's all I've achieved. I started out writing a will halfway down, it turned into a suicide letter. It's painful. Commit suicide. Marriage. People talk about gay marriage. You know what, man? Whether you support gay marriage or not, it don't matter, man. Gay people getting shit done, man. They are, man. What happened to the black agenda? Remember when we used to be the ones getting stuff done? Black people, we just fell off. I don't know what happened. That's the problem with desegregation. It made us lazy and we stopped. I'm just saying, you can't tell me gay people ain't getting more shit done than black people. Every week it's 5 new words you can't say to gay people. They just, that's how they move. They just snatching words out the dictionary, man. Telling me there ain't more respect than black people. Black people been working on niggas since 1804. We still working on our first word, gay people up to 48. Clearly they know something we don't, and we need to reach out and network with they ass and see what the secrets are. Every week, 5 new words you can't call gay people. They have a meeting and then they have a press release. Yeah, stop calling us that word. Which is like, if you don't like the N-word, this is how we get rid of the N-word. Start calling gay people niggas. Why not? Look, they handled all the other words and here's one more. Just take care of that one, Mr. Gay Sir. Now, that's just a concept. I don't want nobody leaving tonight taking initiative. I don't want nobody. Wait till we put that in the Jet magazine, then it's official. Gotta respect gay people, man. They just don't mess around, man. You can't even say gay no more. That's how strong they are. I can't even say, just the word gay, just regular ass, just, you use gay the wrong way at work tomorrow. You have to go see Sylvia in HR immediately. Immediately, they pull you off the floor, you have to drive up to Boston and speak to somebody in corporate, and they make you watch a shitty VHS tape on sensitivity, because you mumbled the word gay under your breath. Now, you was by yourself. You wasn't even with another person. You just said gay. You was in the break room, and your chips got stuck in the machine, and the chips, you, give me the chips, you gay-ass machine.
Roy to the office, Roy to the office. Sylvia line two. Thank you a lot, Gotham, appreciate y'all.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Yeah. Benjamin is taking the stage when we return.
Up our last comedian of the evening, but again, it is live. Did not expect this. I'm going to bring up someone very special to me to help me bring up our last comedian of the night. She plays my mother on Sullivan and Son, Miss Jody Long, ladies and gentlemen. How about for Jody, who plays Oaksha? Are you Ocha now, or are you not Ocha?
I'm Ocha now. Steve, I have two questions. Anybody here see the show? Yeah. Okay. Second question. Is the next comedian, is he any good?
Yes.
He's a funny?
Yes.
Okay, otherwise we have to give everybody the money back. Next, we have Owen Benjamin.
Thank you, everybody. All right. Yes. All right. What's up, New York City? Let's do it. Yeah. I'm the white guy in the show, so I can't do the same premises that they do. Like, when I write jokes, I have to limit myself. I'm like, we gotta start calling gay people Nick... Roy, I got a joke for you. I can't do it. You know what I'm saying? What's up? I saw you're like, you better not finish that word. It's a good night tonight. I love New York City. It's a very sexual town, very aggressive. Everyone's like horny and angry here. Everyone's just horny and mad. First time I came here, first time I had a show, I was really confused by how people approached me. I was coming out of a hotel. It's a true story. Guy comes up to me out of nowhere, just goes, hey, can I get your autograph? I was like, all right. So I sign his thing. I'm kind of excited. You know, it's new in my career, and I was really excited. And he just goes, what number are you? And I already know something's kind of wrong, right? So I'm just like, number one. And so I write number one and put a smiley face. I go, who do you think I am? He goes, you play for the Royals. I go, no, I don't, man, I don't. Because I'm like 6'7", like I think I looked like a dude on the Royals. And I go, no, I don't, man. He goes, then why'd you sign my paper? I go, because, dude, you just asked me to. And he just goes, fuck you, and just walked away. And that was the first time I ever signed an autograph in my life. Thank you. I just got a third dog. I'm a big dog lover. I love dogs. I never thought I was going to get a dog until those Sarah McLachlan commercials started wearing me down. Like, they come on late at night when they know you're drunk and alone. They can feel it when you're vulnerable. And most commercials are 30 seconds. Those are like 5 minutes long. And it's just those dogs. Those aren't dogs in those commercials. Those are actors in dog suits. They're just like, in the arms of an angel. And then a voice comes out. It's like, look at the face of this puppy. They're like, his name is Charles. I'm like, my grandpa's name's Charles, you know? And they're like, he doesn't know why he's being beaten every day. I'm like, why the fuck is he being beaten? And I'm drunk, so I commit. So I got a dog based off those commercials. And then I started volunteering at a shelter. Don't do it, dude. That's why I have three. Because you're volunteering, you're like, adopt a dog. Then they're like, oh, these are gonna die. I'm like, not on my fucking watch. You know, then you're like, I'm like, let's get the hell out of here. Now I have three goddamn dogs. So I had to stop volunteering. Because I'm like, he's not dying. Not with the big bear. I like your pants. I don't know why everyone's being a dick. I like them, stylish. The thing I like about dogs is they're very positive, you know? They're very positive. Like, people get down on themselves for no reason. We just get bummed out. We're like, I'm fucking sad. You know, it's like my friend didn't text me back. Like something so dumb, like the fact we're alive is incredible, and we forget because our brains are too big. A dog's brain is so small that it's perfect for happiness, right? You're like, today sucks, there's a fucking cloud, right? And that's when your dog comes out of nowhere. He's like, you got a ball? I'm like, yeah, why? He's like, what do you mean why? Fucking throw it, dude. So I throw the ball. He's like, no way, it's a ball. Ah! And then he comes back. He's like, bro, that's the best thing that ever happened to me. I'm like, what do I do? He's like, throw it again. I'm like, I just did it. He's like, it's going to bounce different. It's a whole new adventure. I'm like, how long do I do this for? He's like, until I fucking die, dude. This is it for me. Waking up can be hard without a dog, right? You want to wake up. You're like, I don't feel like getting out of bed. Your dogs are already up. They're like, I can't believe we're still alive, bro. They're like, I closed my eyes last night. I thought I fucking disappeared because I don't know what sleep is. I open my eyes. Guess what? I'm back. So's my best friend. What are we going to do today? Thank you. And thanks, guys. And his tail, it's called an anticipatory wag. It starts going like this. Like, it's not ready to commit to the emotion, but it's like, he's like, say it. I'm like, what? He's like, if you stay outside, this wag's gonna go fucking a lot bigger. I'm like, outside. It's like, that's a promise. We're going outside. We're going outside. I don't have a lot of time, so I'm gonna play you guys some music real fast. You guys like music? All right. I'm gonna restart it. Yeah, one sec. I know it's live. All right, hang on. I fixed it, live. Yeah, suck it. Suck it, America. I'm handy as shit. I moved a button. I think music makes me laugh. I've been playing music since I was a little kid, and I think the state of hip hop's getting a little weak. I like the Roots and I like musical hip hop, like the Roots and Tribe and shit like that. But this dude Timberland came out with this big hit in 08 called "It's Too Late to Apologize," and I got on board. I'm like, that song kicks fucking ass, right? So I got it, and I'm like, it's great. It's not by Timberland, it's by One Republic. This is the only thing Timberland adds. Ready? Hey, hey, hey. That's all he does. And we're so dumb and frankly scared of black people that we won't acknowledge it. We're like, you're not adding any lyrics or music. Can you imagine if Timberland produced Beethoven? It was like, crowd, I gotta wrap shit up pretty fast here. I didn't realize it went by so fast. I killed so hard, there was just so much applause that I couldn't fucking. I know. Look, Ahmed got so much more material in.
Do it.
I'm just joking, I was making fun of my buddy. I love, like, relationships are a good time. My parents have been married 40 years. I like watch that shit. I got no time. I love the enthusiasm. Anyway, the big fights are usually the guy's fault, the little fights are the girl's fault. Big fights, like, why are we bankrupt? Like, why'd you pee on my mom's shoes? Like, shit like that. Once a year, we do something fucked up, right? The vast majority of fights are started by women. They have something called soap opera eyes, where they look at you and this music's in their head. It's like a tsunami on a sunny day. It comes out of nowhere, right? Like your girl's like, are you hungry? You're like, no. She's like, where did you eat? I'm like, I ate at Wendy's. She's like, Wendy's. Who the fuck is Wendy? Ladies, you want to know? I got one more tag. You want to know what's in a man's head from birth until death? That's it. We're just like, touch my dick. This is a conversation. Touch my dick. Fucking touch my dick. I don't know how to wrap it up. That's my time. I'm Owen Benjamin. I haven't done a fucking 9-minute set in a while. You guys are awesome. Yes.
suck my dick!
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City. Welcome back to the Access TV presentation of Gotham Comedy Live. More laughs happening right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, just want to take a second and thank you all so much for coming out. We want to thank Access TV, Gotham Comedy Club. They've been awesome. Thank you guys so much for your support of the show. We actually will return for season 2 June 13th on TBS at 10 o'clock, 9 Central. But to be honest, none of us would be here on the stage without one gentleman. Our executive producer is here tonight. He's in the back. How about a round of applause for Mr. Vince Vaughn, everybody? So you better go see the internship. Ladies and gentlemen, Roy Wood, Gareth Reynolds, Owen Benjamin, Ahmed.